come back here for new engineering. So we want to give you all you have to know on engineering section. So welcome back again for new engineering. So we need to teach you how you can then complete this year 55. How long is that, Jay? 55. That is 5550 or 5500. So anyone that you have or you are using. So I think this is the black. So just want to repeat this black right now. Just want to teach you how you can be able to refill this black very, very easy and very, very understandable for you to understand it. Then this is the color pool. This is for the color. That is the magenta color. Yeah, you can see that this is the magenta color. We have the magenta color, then we have also the black color. But we just want to refill this black right now. Then we have, this is the color one for maybe all these 25 meter switch, all those small printers, the small laser jet color prints. So maybe if you check on our previous of our video, we see that's how we refill this color printer and how we'll be able to change the drone that is on it. Maybe if you check in our previous of our video, you will see it and you understand it very, very well. So we just want to teach you how you can be able to refill this color laser jet 5550 or 5500, anyone that you have. So this is how you can be able to refill it. But sometimes, mostly, most people use this side to refill it. You just lose it like this. You have to remove the spring first. You have to remove the spring. You can see, you have to remove that one. Then lose it from here. You just have to lose it very, very well. Then lose it. Make sure there is a two knots that is attached to this, so you have to use it very well. Then use the second one. Yeah, then open it like this. Yeah, yeah, open it. I think you can see a hole that is here. This is where you can easily remove it and refill it very, very easy. But if you want to service it entirely, this is how we're going to do it. You need to remove this pin that is, you can see this pin right now. So you have to remove this pin and this other pin that is here. Always make sure you move the pin very, very well so that you can easily refill it. Yeah, so let's remove it. You have to use your screwdriver or a tester or a flat. Either you use a tester or use this your flat right now. So any of the flats that you have, anyone that you have. So, but I always use a tester in removing it. So you just have to pull it a little bit up. Pull it a little bit up. When you pull it a little bit up, then you can use your screwdriver, the plier. I mean to say, yeah, you use your plier to remove it. Then you have to use the air and remove it easily. Then you have done with that one. Then from this one, the same process that you have to use on it. So you need to pull it up a little bit again. Pull it up. Always make sure that the tester is reaching there very, very well so that you can easily remove it. Yeah. Once you pull that one up, then use your test plier also. Then remove it. Remove it. It's very, very easy to remove. If you know how, you can be able to open it. I think this one is a little bit hard. It's not yet open right now. It's not yet. The pin is not yet out. So you need to push it very, very well. You need to push it very well. Then use the plier and remove it. Use the plier to remove it. Yeah, I think you can see that, but I think it takes us a little bit hard to remove. Let's remove it. This is how you can detach it. Open it this way. I think you can see that already. Then if you want to fill it in, this is where you are going to fill it in. This is a magnetic roller, or you can call it a roller that is rolling it. As you can see, done with that one. Then lose the knot that is here, the two knots that is here. So you have to remove it so that you can easily refill it through this way. Let's just remove it. Let's just lose it. Let's just lose it. Yeah, I think that one is already removed. Then detach it from here. Then push the knot. Then by this side, push it from here. I think you can see. Yeah, remove the roller. This is the roller. Place it by the side. Then maybe you can remove the this what do they call it? The down ruler or the what do you call it? The Dr. Blade. That is Dr. Blade that is on it. So we have to remove this Dr. Blade light now. Have to remove this Dr. Blade so that it can easily refill the toner immediately. So we need to remove the Dr. Blade. Have to remove the Dr. Blade. Detach the knot on it. Lose the knot on it. When you are done resolving it, then remove the Dr. Blade from here. I think maybe we haven't removed this one, or it's taking a little bit hard to remove. So you detach it from it. There is a this thing that is holding it, so you have to remove it gently. Yeah. I think it's already removed. Dr. Blade. When you remove the Dr. Blade finish, then have to fill in the toner, put in the toner that is on it. You shake it. Always make sure that you shake the toner before refilling it. So just need to put a. You want to use a paper so that you can use it like maybe something like a funnel or what they call it or any thing that you want to refill. Just shake it very very well. Then fill. Put it by the side and refill it. And we'll refill. So this is how we do it. So that is how we refill it. Refill it this way. Always make sure that your paper is placed by the side or inside the toner tank so that you can easily refill it. Then you pour the toner. So this is where you can put the pepper, then pour the toner. Pour the toner very, very well. Always make sure that it goes around it. Put it very well. Once you're done putting that one, make sure you shake it so that the toner will really easily enter very, very well. Put it again. Feel it very, very well. When you're done filling that one, you have to put the second one. Because this toner tank is very very big, it's not as small as this one, what they call it, our 2025 or 20 to 400, any one that you are filling. So have to shake it very very well. Make sure you shake it like 3 to 5 minutes. Make sure you shake that very very well and feel also. Yeah. Then fill it the same process that you're going to use. That is the process that you're going to use with all the whole cartridge, all the color cartridge. That is the process that you're going to use. Then fill it very, very well. Make sure it's well full. Otherwise, it will have maybe whatever it stain on it. Put it very, very well. Once you're done putting it, shake it so that the toner will enter inside very very well, so that it can work very well. Then when you are done, then place the blade back. We have to fix the blade back, assemble it. We have to assemble it, put the Dr. Blade back, place the Dr. Blade. But once you want to put the Dr. Blade inside, always make sure you brush it. It's either you brush it or you can use a what they call it, a tissue paper. Use a tissue paper to clean it also. Use a tissue paper to clean the blade because of the toner that is on it. Just use a tissue paper to clean it very well. Use a tissue paper, clean the blade. But there is something, someone that you always use a kerosene to clean this. You can use a kerosene to clean this. Yeah, you can use a kerosene also to clean this so that you have a good job background. But this is the toner that we just want to fill and show you how to fill the toner. But you're not using the kerosene to clean it because our cartridge is very okay and it's working very very fine. So that is why we are not using the toner to clean it. Yeah, we are done with that one. Then let's tighten it back. We tighten the putting the knot back. You can see assembling it. when you're done assembling that one, then you have to put the magnetic ruler. Put a magnetic ruler. Always make sure it's on this gear unit. Place it back. But once you are placing it back, always make sure you move it. Always make sure you move it. Enter very well. Then it's like the gear is not well placed very well. Then you have to use your hand and hold it this way and push it. Roll it, push it very well. Yeah, I think it has entered. Then fix the adjusting bar again. So this is the hole that is always fixing this hole. Fix it back. Yeah, I think it has entered. Then now tighten the knots. Now find the knots. Tighten it very well. Tighten the second one also. Tighten the second one. Once you are done tightening, you have thick cover here right now. Use the cover. The cover here. Placing. Yeah, I think it's set. Then also use your knot and tighten it. This is just, we are just assembling the knot very well. I think if you can be able to feel this, it's very, 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 very important and it's very, very tightening. Always make sure you use your brush. Use your brush to brush it because of the toner around it or the toner that is. That's stain on the cartridge, so just brush it very well. Let's remove very, very well. Also brush where the gear unit is. Once you are done brushing it, always make sure you roll it from here, from the gear unit. Just turn it. Make sure that the toner is well balanced. Once the toner is well balanced, you know that this is very okay and is also very good to go. Then once we are done that one, we have to move the waste that is on this cartridge drum side. The waste is always on this drum side, so we have to remove the waste now that is on it. So this is how we are going to do it. I know that it's going to take you a little bit time to do, but if you have a time or if you can do it, you can do this very, very well, and it's very, very easy for you to do. So this is how we are going to do it. We just need to lose here this knot that is here. Have to remove this knot. And also, this is the only place that you're going to remove. I think you are not using this screwdriver to remove it. We are just using a normal screwdriver, the small. So you have to remove it this way. Lose it very easily. It's very, very easy to remove. Gently. We are done with that one. You have to move this one. You have to use your tester or use your any of the flats that you have to remove it. So you have to move it gently. I think there is a spring that mistakenly fell out from there, so you have to put it by the side. There is a spring that just fell out from it. So once you are done with that one, then you have this spring that is on it. So I have to remove this spring that is here. So you have to remove it also. Use the same flats to remove it. Use the flats to remove it. I think it's out. Once it's out, you have to use here also. You have to remove the knot that is here so that the drum can easily remove. So let's remove here. Let's remove it. To remove it one after the other, I have to lose it one after the other, and also be very, very careful when you are using it. Then push it this way, drag it from here. Have to lose here, hold here, then drag it up. Push it up. Push it very, very well so that it can easily remove. Yeah, I think you can see that. I think it's already removed. Once you are done removing it, then gently remove the drum unit. Yeah, so this is the drum that is on it. This is the A3 drum. So this one is printing A3 and also A4. Then we have to wrap it. Always make sure you keep your drum in a safe place. Always make sure that your drum is well kept on a safe place. So we have to wrap it with a paper. I think this paper didn't contain it, so we have to use another one so that it will cover the whole of the body. To put it in a safe place. So you always make sure you use the waste paper to wrap it very, very well. Then place it by the side. Once you are done with that one, always make sure that your waste paper is available because of the toner that is around here, because the toner will be much on it. So you have to put your waste paper to remove the waste toner that is on it. So you just need to remove the waste toner that is on it. This is the waste toner that is on it. I think you can see that there is no drum again on it, no drum in it. Then this is the dial roller. You have to remove the dial roller. Then you can easily lose it from here and also here. But we don't have that time in losing it from here and here, because you may have to find a glue or what they call it, a UHG gum. It will have an effect on the this thing when printing. The toner will be dropping from here, so you don't need to lose it, just have to remove it from here. Just need to remove the waste toner, pour it out. Make sure that the waste toner is well removed. I think we have already, removed this waste toner that is on this one, so there's no need for me to remove it. I just need to put it back. Have to use our tissue paper to clean it also, to clean the dial roller. Yeah, use your tissue paper to clean the dial roller very, very well. Use our tissue paper to clean the dial roller. Once you are done with that one, then place it back. Have to place it back also. Yeah, I think we are done that one. Then you have to put your drum back. But before you put your drum back, you have to use a tissue paper to clean the surface of the drum. But do not apply any kerosene or any water on it, because it might damage the drum. So please do not apply any water or kerosene or any object at all. Just use a tissue paper to just clean the surface. Just clean the surface very, very well. Then we'll place it back. And when you are placing it back, always look at the angle right here. There's an angle right here and there is no angle right here. So this is where it's going to enter. You have to place it by the side because of this, this iron that is on it is going to enter into this hole. Now, you can see the angle that is on it. That is where the angle is going to fix so that you can rotate the drum. So that the angle will be rotating the drum, then fix it back. Hold the drum very well, so that you can push the drum, the iron very well, then push it, and make sure it keep at this angle right now, the angle that we showed you before. Make sure it keep there, then push it, so that it will come out from this hole. Push it very well, so that it will come out from the hole. Push it, yeah, I think the hole is out, but I think it's not much. So that is it. That they have to fix the handle. Fix the handle back here. But before you have to fix the angle, make sure that you put the spring that is being removed from it. Make sure you put the spring first before you have to fix the angle. The handle. Fix the spring then before you have to put the angle. Then put it. Yeah, I think it's already set. Then use the same screwdriver that you use. Your small screwdriver. Use your small screwdriver, then tight it. Then tight the second one. Once you are done tightening it, you have to fix your the spring that is on it. There is a small cheap spring that is on it, so you have to fix it back. There is a two small cheap spring that is on it. They have to fix it back. Then put the first one, then you put the second one. But once you are putting it, always make sure that you hold it close to your body. So that it will easily fix. Yeah, I think it's done. I think it have already entered. You can see that already. Then also tight the handle very well. Don't forget to tie the handle because it might be maybe washed away and the drum will not be able to rotate at all. Then you tie the handle. Once you're done tightening the handle, always make sure you roll it. Put your hand by this side and also this side. The end side. That is the end side of the drum. Then we roll it. Roll it this way. This is where you're going to put your hand on it. The two end side, that is where you're going to place your hand and roll it forward, not backward. Because if you roll it backward, you might damage the cleaning blade. The cleaning blade might damage. So once you're done fixing this one, then you have to couple it back with your toner that you refill on it, finish with your refill toner that you have done already. Then assemble it back. Fix it, same process. Same process. They have to put the iron pin that is on it. The iron pin, put it back. Find a system, place it. Yeah, and that one is done. Then put the second one also. Place it very well. Always make sure it's well set before you have to put it. When you are done setting it, then use a back or screwdriver to, you know, push it inside very well. I think it's well set. Then we have our spring that is here. We have to fix this, our spring also. We have to fix it. Yeah, I think it's now set. So this is how we are going to refill this here 55A cartridge. I think our 55A cartridge is ready to use. That is how we're going to refill it. Thank you very much. If you love this our video and if you enjoy our channel, please give it a like. We always do our best to make sure that you smile with us. So that is how we're going to do it. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you can be able to get more of our video that is coming up very, very soon. Yeah. Thank you and do work a wonderful day. Bye. All the best.